five good friends was called to the bar. I'd an appetite fresh and hearty, but I was, as many young barristers are, an impecunious party. I'd a swallowtail coat of a beautiful blue, a brief which I bought of a booby, a couple of shirts and a collar or two, and a ring that looked like a ruby.
A couple of shirts and a collar or two, and a ring that looked like a ruby.
In Westminster Hall I danced a dance like a semi-despondent fury, for I thought I never should hit on a chance of addressing a British jury. But I soon got tired of third-class journeys and dinners of bread and water, so I fell in love with a rich attorney's elderly, ugly daughter.
So we fell in love with a rich attorney's elderly, ugly daughter.
The rich attorney, he jumped with joy and replied to me fond professions. You shall reap the reward of your pluck, me boy, at the Bailey and Middlesex sessions. You'll soon get used to her look, said he, and a very nice girl you will find her. She may very well pass for 43 in the dust with the light behind her.
She may very well pass for 43 in the dust with the light behind her.
The rich attorney was good as his word, the briefs came trooping gaily, and every day my voice was heard at the sessions or Ancient Bailey. All thieves who could my fees afford relied on my orations, and many a burglar I've restored to his friends and his relations.
Many a burglar is restored to his friends and his relations.
At length I became as rich as the Gurney's, an incubus then I thought her. So I threw over that rich attorney's elderly, ugly daughter. The rich attorney, my character high, tried vainly to disparage.
No!
Yes. And now, if you please, I'm ready to try this breach of promise of marriage.
And now, if you please, I'm ready to try this breach of promise of marriage.
For now I'm a judge.
I'm a judge too.
Yes, now I'm a judge.
I'm a judge too.
Though all my law be fudge, yet I'll never, never budge, but I'll live and die a judge.
I'm a judge too.
It was managed by a job.
And a good job too.
It was managed by a job.
And a good job too.
It is patent to the mob that my being made a knob was effected by a job.
And a good job.
Couple of shirts and a collar or two, and a ring that looked like a ruby.
A couple of shirts and a collar or two, and a ring that looked like a ruby.
In Westminster Hall I danced a dance like a semi-despondent fury, for I thought I never should hit on a chance of addressing a British jury. But I soon got tired of third-class journeys and dinners of bread and water, so I fell in love with a rich attorney's elderly, ugly daughter.
So we fell in love with a rich attorney's elderly, ugly daughter.
The rich attorney, he jumped with joy and replied to me fond professions. You shall reap the reward of your pluck, me boy, at the Bailey and Middlesex sessions. You'll soon get used to her look, said he, and a very nice girl you will find her. She may very well pass for 43 in the dust with the light behind her.
She may very well pass for 43 in the dust with the light behind her.
The rich attorney was good as his word, the briefs came trooping gaily, and every day my voice was heard at the sessions or Ancient Bailey. All thieves who could my fees afford relied on my orations, and many a burglar I've restored to his friends and his relations.
And many a burglar is restored to his friends and his relations.
At length I became as rich as the Gurney's, an incubus then I thought her. So I threw over that rich attorney's elderly, ugly daughter. The rich attorney, my character high, tried vainly to disparage.
No!
Yes. And now if... I, good friends, was called to the bar. I'd an appetite fresh and hearty, but I was, as many young barristers are, an impecunious party. I'd a swallowtail coat of a beautiful blue, a brief at your board of a boobie.